about to play a concert tune we hope you will enjoy. Thank you.
Good man. You guys know I'm also, I also did that. believe this is for the live feed. It's not for the room.
That wasn't very loud.
That's for the live feed.
Oh, it is. That's why it's not so loud.
Did I say that? Or no?
No, I didn't hear you very well, so I thought maybe the mic wasn't working.
Say that it's odd knowing so many people. I'm usually playing to just a faceless crowd of nerds, jazz nerds. You know, granted they have deep, you know, institutional jazz knowledge. You people are probably shaky, but no, not except for you. You're always listening. I had a whole thing, but I think I'm just going to play. We're going to start with a Thelonious Monk tune called Monk's Dream. And for the uninitiated, this is Monk back here on that white canvas, okay? The music of Monk came to me in a little bit of an odd way. When I was in junior high school, I had to have a hernia operation after hiking the Appalachian Trail. So I was holed up for a bit. And one of the guys that was on the trip, he seemed like an older guy, but he's probably late 20s the most. He came by and brought me this album, Thelonious Monk's Dream. And he handed it to me and he just said, "You have to hear this." And then he split. So I'm looking at this, and I'm like, what the hell is this? And I kept hearing it as the loneliest monk, which is not sexy. You know, it's like kind of a turnoff, right? But then I put it on, and, you know, some kind of pin dropped that led to a whole life of jazz, for better and worse. So here's our version. My God, almost 50 years after Bob Baker handed me that record, we're going to play Monk's Dream. Thank you. Introduce these guys, for Christ's sake, best in the business, Peter Smith. Mike Gurrola, young and hungry like I used to be before they broke me. Okay. My man, Charles Ruggiero. I should mention that Charles has got an incredible band dedicated to the music of Thelonious Monk, and they play regularly at the Baked Potato. I was there Wednesday. Come on, do it. The best. Best in the business. Okay, what am I doing? Yeah, like, it's like in Hollywood, like, you know, one for me, one for you. Right? Okay, so that last one was for us. This one's for you. And if you don't know this tune, I mean, you're not living your best life, okay? Stop, put down the TV remote. And all right, I'm done. Seriously, this is George Gershwin's Summertime. Am I right? Who's with me? Okay, thank you. Petey, you got it.
Thank you.
I had to work real hard to get back in shape for this. Just letting you people know that. I moved to New York when I was 20 years old to play jazz. I had an apartment on the corner of 42nd Street and 8th Avenue.
Oh, wow.
All right? This was not Giuliani's logo-infested, gentrified Times Square. Okay, for real. This was Scorsese's Taxi Driver. And every night I would put my horn in a canvas duffel bag to kind of, you know, camouflage it. And I'd get on the subway and I'd go downtown to play. There were two important jam sessions at that time. These guys know all this shit.
We're going to play in a minute.
I feel like a couple hungry lions back here. So one of the sessions was called the Jazz Forum right near NYU, and the other was the Star Cafe on 23rd Street. So I heard a yay over here. This guy knows. And for me, I mean, God, these were star-studded events. On any given night, coming into play could be Cedar Walton, Junior Cook, Randy Brecker, Dave Liebman. You don't know any of these names, do you? You do. And around that time, I had a steady gig at the Figueroa Cafe on Bleecker Street, right next door to the Village Gate. And one night, after I had just played my favorite ballad, this woman comes up to the bandstand and gets in a little too close and says, "Why does everything you play have to be so sad?" And then she said, "My best friend is having a terrible time with her boyfriend, and your music is not helping." We're going to play that song right now. It's very sad. Okay? But it is a beautiful song. It's by the saxophone player Benny Carter, and it's called Souvenir.
Thank you.
I don't think I see a dry eye in the house. Real jazzy song for you. You're real jazzy. You know, I told you that, like, I had to work real hard in getting back in shape, you know, play with these guys, because I do have another life these days. But, you know, playing jazz is like riding a bike. There's no money in riding a bike. My man.
That's pretty good.
My man. Thank you. There we are. Let's fix that in post. Paul, get that rim shot in there. All right. I'm a post guy.
Who did we say wrote the horse part?
Okay. Mike, you know, I mean, this guy's young and hungry, knows everything. He's a bad boy. So. Minor Chant, and it's written by Horace Parlan. That's all I got about that.
Do you remember that? Yeah, it was about here, right?
Want me to count?
Yeah, please.
One, two, and. Thank you.
I know it's sort of a jive thing to say, but I'm going to say it anyway. For jazz musicians to say this, but we've never played together. How about that? You know? So, I mean, we went over a couple things, made it sure that we were in the right keys, right tempos, but I just want to let you know that this is what happens when you're dealing with professionals, okay? I'm not fucking around, okay? I want to just address the fact that, like, I know so many of you really well that came here, and I really appreciate it. It's kind of like I manifested the perfect audience with all my favorite people. It's good stuff. I had a punchline in there. It's gone. You know, that's what I like to do. I hit you in the feels, and then you know, like a joke. I forgot the joke. I was getting all choked up. But thank you for coming. I really appreciate that. We're going to play just an old standard. I don't know anything about it other than the great Hank Mobley recorded this tune. And it's called I Should Care.
You want to play something up front?
Yeah.
Thank you.
You could tell that one felt good, right? You could tell. That felt good. You know, playing is hard. It's hard. I'm not trying to humble brag here. I'm not. But it's hard. You know, I'm not at the top of my game technically. Let me be clear here, because I'd like to think at this point in my life I'm a more rounded human being. But when I was in my 30s, man, I could play any tempo, any key, you know? And I had a round tone that was very much in tune. The only problem was that I couldn't satisfy a woman. So, you know, it all worked. It all balances out. I could play fast, but, you know, who cares? Oh, we got a great tune coming up. This is an arrangement by Peter. And, yeah, look, while we're at it, how about give it up again for Mike Gurrola. Ridiculous. And my man, Charles Ruggiero on drums. Very strong. All night long. Thank you. either Nathan's dad or art director, designer, animator guy, somebody to do like a lot of mushrooms with. You gotta have hobbies, you know. So I was recently asked to art direct and animate on a documentary about Horace Silver. And I was thinking about this. I was thinking, like, if there was one person's complete musical catalog that I would, you know, answer the desert island question with, it would be Horace. That music satisfies all the dietary requirements that I personally need. Mm-hmm. Starting with Hank Mobley, who I just love, Hank Mobley. Anyway, we're going to do a Horace Silver tune right now called Strollin'.
Is it that same tempo?
Yes. It'd be like exactly the same.
God damn it.
Oh, the web analytics just told me that we just lost 25,000 listening to the live stream. Oh, God. I think it was my stories. Hold on. What do we got? Oh, my God. How did we miss that?
I don't know, man. It's your show.
That's crazy.
That is the thing. That's the truth. That's my fault. Because I've been mostly a side man. I blame it on the leader. Now it's me. All right. Yes. Oh, we're going to get very jazzy now. All right. This is a Jackie McLean tune recorded by Miles and Coltrane on the Roundabout Midnight album. I love that version. Philly Joe on that version. But this is by Jackie McLean, and it's called Little Melanie.
Thank you. Mezquida. I first met Alan playing a terrible gig with a lot of famous people in the audience. The Sunset Towers Hotel in the Sunset Strip. It was like half of CAA is there any night. And this bass player, Joey Altruda, was playing with me, and he said, "There's an alto player from New York who I think you're really going to like." I was like, how are we going to have an alto player in this thing? And it's all like, they're all making deals in the corner, and like, it's going to be loud, and they're going to fire us. You know? And then Alan shows up, and he's like in the corner, you know, and Joey's here, and the piano's right there, and he's just like. And we became instant friends. I was like, yeah, this is my guy. I put him in Molly Ringwald's band, and we went all over the country, and. So Alan Mezquida, everybody. I know this is weird, like we're not amplified, but this is for the, you know, the people watching. Thank you for coming to my space. Thank you for watching at home. If you are watching and want to buy a virtual ticket, there are links in the text box to do that. All the things, PayPal, Venmo. I have the mailing list is circling around here if people want to sign it on their way out, or Jess, you can even send it around if people want to do that. And our next one is April 21st. We do one a month on the Sundays at 4 p.m. It's going to feature Michael Carvin, who's a master drummer, played with Jackie McLean, Hampton Hawes, Freddie Hubbard. Was a mentor to all of my favorite drummers, pretty much. I'm lucky enough to be in his trio. He just moved out to LA from New York, and he's 78 years old. Wow. And so we're gonna do his trio here on April 21st. And then I don't know what May is yet, but if you join my newsletter, yeah. He makes it up the stairs. Join my newsletter. I send one email a month. I won't spam your inbox. And that's about it. I give it back to Alan.
management that we're going to wrap it up here.
All right, we're going to do one more quick one, but slow. But it's going to be a slow, quick one. Just a blues. We're going to play some blues. Bags Groove at Charles Tempo of Choice.
It's the jazzdive.com, or if you're, you can scan your phone on these things, if, for those of you here, if you're interested in ordering these, they're obviously gorgeous, very evocative. So, and for everyone watching at home, it's the jazzdive.com is the website. And Alan and Karen have been gracious enough to, I mean, these are going to live in my studio. So hopefully everybody will come and check them out and order them, and you know, it's really amazing work. All right.
Thank you. Gurrola, Charles Ruggiero.
Resident genius. Paul does sound for the Jazz Bakery. He builds fancy ribbon microphones. He's my friend and great. You know, I couldn't do this without him.